surprise, it's Carl from Studio Incar, and our new car has just turned up. Let's go and have a look. It's turned up on a Russell's Motorsport lorry, which is pretty special. And there it is, the GT4, absolutely chuffed with it. It's good client of ours, James, and we bought it off of him because of the work that we've already done to it. There's a full series on this car, and we can, you know, we can demonstrate this to our other clients, and yeah, so nice one for the opportunity, James, and here it is. So yeah, over the next few days we're going to run you through this again, have a look at this series, but we're probably going to carry on with it. So we're probably going to move a couple of little bits around and stuff like that, and then drive it, because that's what it's all about. You know, this system's a relatively large system for a car like this, but care's been taken to balance out all of the product. You know, we've minimised the weight we've added. And if you watch this series that we put up, the panels of fabrication that we've made are intentionally quite lightweight. So yeah, it's a good all-rounder. Good all-rounder. It's a very very happy day. It's been a bad year, you know, for everybody. So what is life if you can't treat yourself every now and again? We've treated ourselves to this lovely GT4. Yeah, a successful delivery from Russell's Motorsport Logistics. Shout out to you. To get it indoors. Exciting start. Thank you.
So as you've just seen, first wash, that bond that any car guy knows, when you get a new car, you have to give it a little, you know, a little tickle, give it a little wash, get amongst it, and then it sort of starts to feel like yours, you know. You'll appreciate that. Let's have a look at why we chose to buy this particular GT4 off of our client, James. So not only is it a GT car, Cayman GT4, it also has one of our systems. We put a lot of time and effort into this. We know the system, we know the previous owner, we know his team, so we know James, we own Inspired Automotive, CLP Automotive as well, that does his sort of servicing and everything. These guys are up north, but they're a good team, which makes it a valuable thing to us, because knowing the history of it and everything like that just makes it much safer sort of thing. But you know, like I was saying, it's got one of our systems in that we can, we have a lot of clients with similar cars, but they struggle to sort of get over the line with the decision because they can't see something here that has a similar reward for the purchase. So we'll keep this here. You know, I'll probably use it more than you would expect, because it's a car at the end of the day, but it'll be here and it'll be able to be demonstrated to people, to yourself and whoever really. But yeah, let's have a little recap. You know, we've done a, as I've said earlier in the video, we've done a whole series on this car, so feel free to go back and have a look. I certainly did when we decided to take the car, just to remember, you know, well, how good the car is really. So in the front we've got our amplifier rack, really, really light, custom fabrication. There's an AV 51K and an AV Quattro. Down in the belly down there is an Alderson Bit1 HD Virtuoso. It's doing DSP, running from the factory head unit. And then, so running from the factory head unit, we've also got a Sony RSX GS9 inside there for high res, so that we can stream to on the digital input for the DSP. So in the doors, we've got Alderson Thesis mid bass, we've got Alderson Thesis tweeters in the OEM locations up front. And at the moment, we've got Hertz Miele mid range, but we'll probably adjust that, just to get the three-way Thesis in there in the rear. It's custom fabricated panel. We wanted a sort of air-cooled, sort of 911 vibe in there. Underneath there is an Isatar 1200, so 12-inch sub-bass driver from Dyne Audio, in another fabricated floor with sort of lighting. We'll see if you can probably see the glow from here. And there you can just catch it through the grill. It's a Swiss Army knife of what we do this car. It really is, and you know, we've got fabrication in the rear, we've got fabrication up front, we've got OEM integration, we've got high res, you know, direct to the DSP. You know, from inside the cab, you wouldn't know anything has been done other than the sound. So there's so many angles that you can see what we do and why we do certain things, and then we can flip it and show things like, you know, fabrication. Under this floor is even less subtle, you know, so we can show that sort of show and display fabrication for sort of show car situations and things like that, or just pride of ownership stuff. But yeah, you know, and on top of it all, it's an awesome sounding car, you know, the actual sound system, you know, it works. It's not just in there for the sake of it, you know, it's a really nice sound, and it's a Cayman GT4, so it's a lovely car to drive. You know, we've added probably 25 kilos, something like that, maybe slightly less, because we've removed a bunch of stuff as well, spread evenly throughout the car, you know. So yeah, just for those purists of you that would complain that we
have ruined a GT4. We haven't. Come and see it, drive it, you know. So yeah, anyway, still doesn't feel real at the moment, but we'll get there. Take it easy, guys. That's this video done. Just reintroducing you to this. You'll see it more and more in the videos now because it'll be in the background. We've got a, it may have already been shown, it may not, but we've just done some wicked work to the caddy as well, with 10 inch mid bases in the front of there. Caddy is about 80% done now, so we'll probably move on to the T5 next, but we've got a you know, a lot of projects coming up. We've got a brilliant T6.1 project that's happening now. It's just a way, with Mike from New Wave Camper Conversions, having a floor and stuff put in for us. The trim is with Steve from Edge Automotive, and yeah, when we get that back, we'll start flying on that. So we'll put that out on sort of Instagram and things like that. And then, you know, all sorts of other cool stuff going on as well. We've got a couple of Vianos, R32 that's in next week, and we'll shoot all of them. So yeah, that's the Cayman. So take it easy and have a nice Christmas.